Hello and welcome to my YouTube channel. Today I will be working with the Sticky Dan August 2021 double page sketch, and I will be scrapping some photos taken on a recent day out with my family. And here I'm just going through the papers and the embellishments I'm planning to use. Most of these come from a kids subscription club. And I've been quite neglectful in using my kids in recent months. So what I've done is I amalgamated about 3 kits, and I just pulled papers that I thought would go well with my photos. And these are mostly blues and pinks with the occasional bit of orange as well, which I'm hoping will be popping quite nicely on my layouts. So here I'm just making a start on the right hand side of the layout, and instead of using 4 photos as suggested on the sketch, I'm using 3 photos, and I'm replacing the 4th one with a journaling spot, which I cut out from an Amy 10 cut apart sheet. So this cut apart sheet comes from her latest collection, which is called Brave and Bold, and I really quite like this collection. I'm strangely drawn to the oranges in this collection, which is quite unusual for me because orange is the least favorite color of mine in scrapbooking. So in here I'm just cutting out a little mat from the B side of the cut apart sheet, and then I'm placing the journaling spot on top. And I have also punched out 3 circle shapes from the same sheet of paper, which I will be using in the embellishment clusters. So in here, I'm just making a start on the left-hand side of the layout. And what I'm doing here is, rather than using 2 smaller photos which are vertically orientated, I'm using a larger horizontal photo. So I make a start on the pattern papers, and I tried to follow the sketch quite closely, but I didn't like how those 2 pattern papers were separate, which created a bit of a trap space in the middle. So in the end I just tucked one under the other instead. I also introduced a wood grain paper, which I thought would go quite well with the theme. And then in here I'm trying to follow the sketch and use the same patterned paper on the left hand side as I did on the right hand side, but I didn't like how it looked. It seemed like a bit of a weird extension of the paper. So in the end I replaced it with that scattered floral paper, which is also from the Amy 10 collection. It does include that orange color that I talked about earlier, and this was a really good way of introducing that orange to the layout. And in here I'm just gutting one of the papers, which is probably making a lot of people cringe, so I'm so sorry about it, but this is just something I do because I'm quite a stingy crafter, and I really like the butterflies on the B side of this paper, and I wanted to use them on this layout, so it made sense to cut a few of them out. And then it's time to stick everything down. And I make a bit of a mistake here. When I cut the floral paper, I cut it too small and it doesn't stretch beyond parameters of the photo. So in the end, I'm having to cut it into 2 pieces and tuck them in at the top and at the bottom of the wood grain paper, but that's okay. And because I didn't like how the photo was blending into the background, I decided to mat it onto a contrasting piece of cardstock, and this orangey yellowy cardstock was perfect. Although I do now wish that I used the B side of it instead of the A side, which was a more intense color, but never mind. It did create that division between the photo and the pattern papers, so that was okay. And then it was time to make a start on the embellishing. So I allocated 3 spots for the embellishment clusters, and then I chose a square piece for the central piece on the right hand side. I wanted to mat it onto patterned paper or cardstock just to make it a bit more visible, and I ended up matting it onto the yellowy orangey cardstock, which was a perfect way of bringing that color over to the right hand side. And then I made the start properly on the embellishment clusters, and I did what I usually do, which is using very similar elements in the embellishment clusters just to create cohesion and bring the two sides of the layout together. And these pieces included the punched out circles, butterflies, a fray sticker, and I was also thinking about adding some acrylic pieces. So the butterfly embellishment pieces have been fussy cut from the patterned paper, and I'm just creasing the paper up to be able to lift the wings of the butterflies a bit, just to add a bit of dimension to the layouts. And what I'm doing is that I'm sticking them down flat behind the photos and adding small foam adhesive pieces to lift the tops of the wings of the layout. And then I'm just repeating the same thing in all 3 embellishment clusters. And I'm entertaining the idea of adding some extra embellishments, but somehow they just don't seem to fit at all. So I just stick with the original plan. And it makes sense not to overcrowd the embellishment clusters because the layout is already quite busy with all the photos and all the pattern papers. But I do decide to add some acrylic pieces to the layout. I did choose some small heart-shaped pieces, and these are quite neutral in color. So they're little white and off-white hearts, as well as the odd pale gold one. The pale gold ones go quite well with the orange on the layout, and because they're quite neutral, they don't stand out from the background, so they don't add busyness to the layout. I did cut out a little bit of the process video in here. So I added some gems to the embellishment clusters as well, which was off camera, and also the little yellow acrylic arrow, which I thought was quite a good addition. And then I made a start on the title. I was quite stuck. I was in a hurry with this layout. I couldn't think of an original title. The word wonder came to mind, but I've got so many layouts with wonder often and wonder always and all that. So I just didn't think it was a particularly good title anyways. And I didn't really like the colors. The pink was just too bright and it didn't go with the rest of the layout. So in the end, I decided to replace the title with a sentiment, which was a much better fit to the story, really. And because the pink on it was more of a corally reddish hue, I just wanted to reinforce that a bit more. So I just added the little banner above it, and I tried to add another banner to the right hand side just to introduce that shape to that side as well, but it really wasn't working, so I just left it at that. Thanks so much for visiting my YouTube channel and watching my process video. And as always, don't forget to check back to the Stick It Down blog throughout the month for weekly inspiration. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.